Hey, it's Sean from Tested coming to you from my home workshop during our shelter at home time in the Bay Area. We're all good. My family's fine. This is kind of almost normal for me because I usually work from home. So not leaving the apartment for a week is not abnormal, which is kind of sad, I guess. But regardless, we're okay. Everything's going fine. So I thought I'd check in, show you some stuff I'm working on, maybe give you some ideas of stuff to watch or do to occupy your time. So first off, we're actually doing something very useful and putting my 3D printing skills to use, and we are doing some PPE gear. These are headbands, a design from Sweden for face shields. And it's great that we are able to do this as a maker community. I would just say make sure that you are vetting items that you're going to produce. There are some things, particularly 3D printed respirators, which are not safe or responsible to print, in my opinion. The face shields are pretty easy to do and are definitely acceptable. These orders came directly from a hospital, so I feel pretty good about doing those. There's another really good design from our friends at Prusa Research that they did a really nice face shield design as well. We'll try to post links for all that stuff. And I'd recommend trying to work through a hub. I'm working through Matter Hackers, which is a local 3D printing company, fabric supply and retailer in the California area. And they've been doing a fantastic job at coordinating between the medical facilities and fabricators. And I've been doing that and it's been working out really well. So I'd suggest you try to do the same thing. So if you can make stuff, do it. Help out when you can. So fun stuff that we've been working on is all kinds of projects. So number one, I've been continuing to fix movie cameras. These are some 16mm Arri-S cameras that are from Germany. I just happen to have two people send these in. One actually the whole way from Germany, surprisingly couldn't find someone in Germany to fix it. So I'm working on these. They're still making 16mm motion picture film. I still fix these for CalArts, so I'm glad to see these things going still. It's awesome, and they're fun to work on. The other thing I've been doing is we have a new Ghostbusters film coming out, hopefully this summer still, and I've been working on a lot of Ghostbusters stuff. You may know that Jeremy Williams and I did a 3D printed and designed Ghost Trap a few years ago. He did all the electronics, I did the mechanical design, and it is fully functional. We had a lot of fun doing this. We actually released the files for it on Thingiverse so you can print out your own if you want something to do during the quarantine. But I've been working on doing simplifications to it, like instead of 3D printing these giant flat panels that are on the top and bottom, I've been trying to fabricate them out of 3D laser cut acrylic instead. It's a little more expensive material-wise, but it saves a lot of time on the fabrication and finishing because it's already nice and smooth, so not too much sanding or cleanup to do. I can just kind of spray paint it and I'm done. So upgrades on our original, but I've also been getting a lot of requests for upgrades for the Spirit Halloween trap. So Spirit Halloween has been putting these out. They run $30 to $50, and overall, they're like the right general shape and design and everything. They actually have some nice little function. So it's a nice cheap alternative, and not everybody wants to tackle a big build like my original. So the problem with this is it's not that accurate. And so I've been doing 3D printed and laser cut upgrades. So like we added the missing plate, we added an accurate knob, more accurate vector plate, and the missing Foster connector that's back here. And just kind of overall doing some like visual improvements, knobs, wheels, etc. So that's been fun. I've been plugging away at that. If you're into the Spirit Trap, I'd highly recommend checking out our friend Bill Duran of Punished Props. did an excellent upgrade and reprint paint of a spirit trap. And there's some really good tips and techniques in there. So check that out as well. And hopefully I'll have some parts out there soon that you can check out. Continuing the Ghostbusters craze, we go to these guys. What could these be? Well, it is Dr. Venkman's ESP negative reinforcement machine. I love it. My friend Jordan found this at a flea market. He instantly knew what it was, picked it up, and he gifted it to me. This is like the best find ever. I love it. And because I have a problem, I found another one on eBay that I also had to pick up. So I did a few upgrades here. The original window that was on this was all yellowed and clouded. And I think it's acetate, and it basically kind of just melted. So I made a new window that I put in there. The original meter on mine was square like this guy. And that's not movie accurate. You need a round one. So I found a round meter that I installed on it to kind of make it a little more accurate to the screen used one. But originally these were pH meters apparently, and they had a whole bunch of batteries inside, which I'll show you. Yeah, old lantern batteries, some in just cardboard sleeves, but amazingly they didn't really leak. So that's kind of cool. And I love this little compartment down here, and I theorized that Dr. Venkman may have a little something stashed down there, so I added that too for fun. So I also did the ESP cards. So these are actually called Zener cards. They're often used in magic shows, and I couldn't find the large ones. I recognize the back as bicycle playing cards, and you can get large bicycle playing cards, like the regular playing cards, but I couldn't find the Zener cards. So I used these excellent Avery vinyl shipping labels, and I made my own. So I just did these in Illustrator, printed them out, put them on, and then just trimmed them with an X-Acto. And it worked great, and they worked particularly well because these are shipping labels. They are meant to block out labels behind it, so you didn't get any bleed through from the actual printed cards. So these turned out well. I just need to get the electrodes, and I'd love to get a fake little piece of gum with like a drool puddle around it to put on top there. So yeah, the ESP negative reinforcement device. Okay, so that's it for Ghostbuster stuff, but we have some recommendations for projects for you at home. I have this embarrassingly large stack of Bandai Star Wars models. We've built these a ton on Tested. They're absolutely fantastic. I highly recommend them. They run anywhere from $20 up to maybe like $40 or more for the bigger ones like the Falcon and the AT-AT. But they're fantastically detailed, and they are all snapped together. No paint required because they mold them in all the correct colors, as you can see from the Shore Trooper here. And the detail is just absolutely fantastic on these. And the figures are great. Let me get some focus here. There we go. The figures are great because they're also jointed. So we have C-3PO. Oh no, his arm's falling off. This is embarrassing. But they are all jointed with these little rubber gaskets that really hold the position well. Really detailed, good stuff. 3PO was a little shiny for my taste, so I hit them with a little bit of fine steel wool, which give them that kind of like mellowed look that you would expect from him in most of the movies. If you're not into Star Wars, you can go to the Bandai Standard, which was the all the Gundams. They are in a variety of scales and designs, all the way up to like 12-inch giant ones. So it just kind of depends on your budget on how much you want to spend. But the Bandai models, highly recommended for a good project. And finally, if you need some quarantine viewing, you know, you might be running out of things to binge, I'd highly recommend a little program on Tested called Bits to Atoms. You may have heard of it. It was Jeremy Williams and I's show on fabrication. We did a lot of fun projects such as the Ghost Trap, Star Lords, which was an arcade cabinet build that we did with software developer Other Ocean here in Emeryville. Most of them are up on YouTube, so you can check them out. There are a few that are still premium content on the Tested website, but there's a lot of fun stuff in there, things I think you'll enjoy. And we even released files for some of the projects, so you can kind of tackle them at home if you want. So check them out. But other than that, I hope you and your family are doing okay. I hope you're staying safe. You know, follow all the safety protocols so we can get through this in one piece together, and we'll be back to our regular schedule at the Tested studio and, you know, back at Adam's Cave and all that stuff, and bringing you more fun projects. So until then, this is Sean from Tested tuning out.